Hello everyone, today I am going to explain you about how to draw velocity triangles. Velocity triangles are the triangles drawn for the velocity of the fluid in hydraulic machines. So these triangles are helpful to find out the efficiency of hydraulic machines. What is meant by hydraulic machine? Hydraulic machine is a machine which uses hydraulic power to do work. There are two types of hydraulic machines. They are pumps and turbines. Pumps are the machines which converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. These turbines are the machines which converts the hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. The generator fitted to that will convert the mechanical energy into electrical energy. Means the turbines are used to generate the electricity, pumps are used to lift the fluids. So before drawing the velocity triangles, we should know the concept of absolute velocity and relative velocity. First, consider a fixed plate. Okay, now I have considered vertical fixed plate. The jet is moving with the velocity v, then the jet will strike the fixed plate at a velocity is equal to absolute velocity itself. It means, for example, if velocity of the jet is 100 meter per second, then the jet strikes the fixed plate at a velocity 100 meter per second itself. So now I'll consider a moving vane. So here I have considered a curved moving vane which is moving with the velocity v. The jet is moving with the velocity v. Since the vane is moving, the speed at which the jet is striking the bucket or the vane is equal to relative velocity, that is the velocity is equal to v minus u. For example, velocity of the vane is 10 meter per second, velocity of the jet is 100 meter per second, then the speed at which the jet is striking the moving bucket or moving vane is equal to 100 minus 10 is equal to 90 meter per second. When the vane is moving, the mass of water which is striking the bucket is equal to rho a v r. Okay. In reality, there will be series of vanes are considered. So when the jet strikes, first bucket receives the water, then it will rotate. Then the next bucket receives the water. This process continues. Now, consider a curved vane. You can see the bending of the vane, right? Isn't it? So, draw a horizontal line, the center. You can measure the bending of both the ends with respect to center. The bending of vane at inlet, any one end you consider as inlet, other end will be outlet. Where the jet strikes, that is considered as inlet, where the water leaves, that is considered as outlet. Okay. So now, the bending of vane with respect to center, right? Here, the bending of the vane is measured with respect to center. At inlet, this is considered as vane angle at inlet, that is theta. Now, the bending of vane at the outlet, it is considered as phi. See, I have marked here, this is bending of the vane at outlet. This is the bending of vane at the inlet. You can see here, right? Look at here. I have considered a fixed curved plate. Now the jet, this is the bending of the vane here. At inlet it is theta, bending of vane at outlet is phi. Then the jet will strike the vane at inlet at a velocity is equal to absolute velocity. Water will go out with the velocity is equal to absolute velocity at an angle is equal to vane angle at the outlet. So the jet will strike at an angle is equal to vane angle at inlet, that is theta. The jet will leave the vane at an angle is equal to vane angle at outlet phi. Okay, so since the vane is fixed, both the ends the velocity will be absolute velocity itself. Okay, see here the bending of vane at outlet and inlet are different, then theta and phi are different. The vane is symmetrical, it means the bending at inlet and outlet are same. It means in case of symmetrical vanes, the theta is equal to phi. Okay, next consider this plate or the vane. Okay, so first you draw a line AB. It represents the absolute velocity V1. When the jet strikes here, it makes the vane to rotate, right? Rotate. It means allow the water to flow. It means so there will be two components of absolute velocity in horizontal direction and vertical direction. So vertical direction, the component is Vf1. The horizontal component is taken as Vw. One refers to inlet. Okay, absolute velocity always will strike at an angle is equal to vane angle at inlet, that is theta. At outlet, okay, I'll name it as 2. The water will go out with the velocity is equal to absolute velocity. There will be two components of absolute velocity in vertical direction, horizontal direction, because the water will leave with an angle is equal to vane angle at outlet. Okay, so with this knowledge, I'm going to explain you about how to draw velocity triangle for the unsymmetric vane. First, I will draw vane. Okay, it's a curved vane. Next, draw a line, okay, which represents absolute velocity. Let V1 is the velocity. V1 is the absolute velocity striking the moving vane. Okay, at one end, which makes an angle alpha with respect to horizontal, or I can write it as this horizontal angle, it is alpha. Okay, so name inlet as 1, outlet as 2. Consider the vane which is moving with the velocity, okay, is equal to u. Since the vane is unsymmetric, the velocity of the vane at inlet is u1. At the outlet, the velocity of the vane is u2. In case of symmetric vane, velocity of the vein at inlet and outlet will be same. So it means U1 is equal to U2. So now I have considered a unsymmetric vein. Okay, it means the inlet angle and outlet angles are different. Now, see, consider the jet which is moving with the velocity is equal to V1. So measure AB. AB represents the absolute velocity in magnitude. Alpha is measured with respect to the direction of motion of the bucket or the vane or with respect to the horizontal. Okay, so when the absolute velocity when the jet strikes the moving bucket causes whirling of water as well as flow of water. Flow takes place in this direction, so the vertical component will be the flow velocity, the horizontal component will be the whirl velocity. Okay, so I will mark now the flow velocity, that is Vf1. 1 represents the inlet. See, I have marked here the horizontal component, right? This represents Vw1. Look at here. V1 is the absolute velocity. The magnitude is represented by AB. Alpha is the striking direction with respect to horizontal or in the direction of the motion of the vane. Now, Vf1 and Vw1, Vw1 are the result component of V1. Okay, what is Vw1? So cos alpha is equal to Vw1 divided by hypotenuse, that is V1. So cos alpha is equal to Vw1 divided by V1. So Vw1 is equal to V1 cos alpha. Then the sine alpha is equal to Vf1 divided by V1. So what is Vf1? Vf1 is equal to V1 sine alpha. Okay. So as I mentioned earlier, the vane is moving, then the jet will strike the moving vane with the velocity is equal to relative velocity. This Vr. The relative velocity will act at an angle is equal to vane angle. Okay. So the distance, the horizontal distance between or the distance measured along the direction of motion of the vane between absolute velocity and relative velocity is taken as vane velocity at inlet. Okay. So here AC represents U1. AD represents VW1. BD represents VF1. 1 refers to the inlet. So alpha is the guide blade angle at inlet. Theta is the vane angle at inlet. Okay. So now, when the jet is striking the moving vane with the velocity Vr1, it will leave the jet, it will leave the vane with the velocity Vr2. Okay. So this angle, the leaving angle is equal to phi, vane angle at outlet. The absolute velocity will, at outlet is equal to B. V2, it will act an angle beta with respect to the direction of motion of the vane. U2 is the velocity of the vane at the outlet. Then the horizontal distance between VR2 and UV2 is taken as U2. The absolute velocity will have two components in horizontal and vertical direction. They are VF2 and VW2. Okay, so take the outlet point as 2, then all the parameters of the velocity which are considered at outlet are represented with respect to 2. That is VR2, V2, VF2, VW2, U2. Now, the triangle EGF, okay, here GF represents U2, GE represents VR2, FE represents V2. When the water leaves the vane at any angle less than 90 degree, means V2 will shift towards the right. Okay. Okay. Now in this triangle, FHE, in this triangle, okay, so VW2 and VF2 are the resolved component of V2. Then how to find VW2 and VF2? That is cos beta is equal to, see, cos beta is equal to, cos beta is equal to here cos VW2, VW2 divided by V. What is VW2 then? VW2 is equal to V2 cos beta. Similarly, what is sine beta? Sine beta is equal to VF2 divided by V2. See, I have written here. Okay. Now, this is the completed velocity diagram. The velocity diagram at a, or velocity triangle at a outlet. This is the velocity triangle at a inlet. Inlet represents the jet striking point. Outlet represents water leaving point. Okay. Next, I am going to explain you about different cases. See here. When the jet strikes at one end in the direction of motion, it means jet is striking at one end along the direction of motion, means the alpha will be 0. So then theta also will become 0. So the triangle B, okay, now B will join to D. So AD is equal to AB is equal to V1 is equal to VW1. AC represents U1. What is relative velocity? The relative velocity VR1 is equal to V1 minus U1. If the vanes are radial at inlet, radial means like a fan. Okay, the blades are straight. Such cases, the vane angle or the blade angle is 90 degree. Okay, the jet may strike with the velocity is equal to absolute velocity here. When the vane is moving, the jet will strike at a velocity is equal to relative velocity is equal to VR1. So here, that is A, and C shift towards D, right? So that time VR1 will be equal to VF1. Next, the discharge at outlet is radial. It means water is leaving the outlet at 90 degree. That sense, beta is equal to 90 degree. So here, the velocity in the triangle, that VW2 will become zero. You should know about the deflection angle. What is deflection angle? It is the outer angle between the striking line and the leaving line of the jet. So here the jet is striking, water may go out here. So the line drawn between this, right, this here, the outer angle is called as deflection angle. The bending of the vane with respect to the inlet. Now consider here the vane, curved vane, the jet is striking at the center. Okay, this is the striking line. The water after striking, right, it will go out here. This is the outlet line. The outer angle is taken as deflection angle. Jet may strike at one end, draw the line, it means tangentially. Water may go out at other end, draw the line here. The outer angle between the striking line and the water leaving line is taken as deflection angle. There are some cases you should know. Jet leaves in the direction of motion at any angle, okay, at outlet, right? Leaves means at outlet. The water leaves at any angle less than 90 degree. It means V2 will make an angle less than 90 degree, means you have to write like this way. Okay, in the direction of motion. The direction of motion of the wave. Okay, maybe 20 degree, 30 degree means it will comes under first quadrant. Okay, then VR2 will be on the left side, VF2 will be vertical. Next, the jet leaves at any angle more than 90 degree. It means in the direction of motion. It means you have to mark like this way. So here, example, 130 degree means it comes under this quadrant. So VR2 will be on the left of V2. VR2 will be left of V2. The blades are symmetrical. It means theta is equal to blade angle at inlet or vane angle at inlet is equal to vane angle at outlet. Also, the velocity of the vane at inlet U1 is equal to velocity of the vane at outlet U2 is equal to U. The vane is smooth. It means there won't be any friction loss. So VR1 is equal to VR2. That is, relative velocity at inlet is equal to relative velocity at outlet. It means what velocity the jet strikes the moving vane, same velocity the water will go out. There is no friction loss. Okay, this is the velocity triangle. Okay, this is just the cases I have explained. The velocity triangles are written here. At outlet, okay, the beta is less than 90 degree. It means VW2 is here, VF2 is here, U2 is here, VR2 is here. Okay. If the jet is leaving the outlet at a 130 degree, it means any angle more than 90 degree with respect to the direction of motion, the velocity diagram looks like this. If the water is leaving the jet radially, water is leaving the vane radially, it means the beta is 90 degree. Okay, with respect to direction of motion, the water is leaving the vane radially, it means 90 degree here. So beta will be is equal to 90 degree. Then velocity diagram at outlet looks like this. Okay. The water at outlet leaves at any angle less than 90 degree with respect to direction of motion. So direction of motion, any angle less than 90 degree. Okay. Then V2 will be on the right side. Okay, like this way. VR2 will be on the left side. VF2 will be perpendicular. Okay. So then GF. Okay, so look at here. Here F is here. The water leaves at any angle less than 90 degree means this F shifts to the right. So U2 will be the distance between G to F. VF2 to V2, the distance is VW2. It means the result component of V2 in horizontal direction is VW2, in vertical direction is VF2. Thank you.